Good morning, New Canaan High School.
I'm Finley Walker, coming to you live from the NCTV studios. Today is Friday, October 25th, and a day B. Something about this broadcast is a little different, if you haven't noticed.
I have no idea what you're talking about, Finley. Everything seems pretty normal to me.
Maybe it's because you're finally back in the anchor seat, Brendan.
That I am, Finley, and we have a jam-packed broadcast. But before we can get into all of it, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
If you walked by the lobby, you've probably seen the theater headshots of some of our talented underclassmen. That must mean that there's a play going on. We go to Chloe DeMauro for all the details.
Hey NCHS, I'm Chloe DeMauro here on the auditorium stage where students are busy putting the final touches on this year's underclassmen play, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. You probably remember reading Mark Twain's classic novel years ago, but here to give you a quick refresher is sophomore Berlin Charles, who is playing Ben. So Berlin, can you take a second to walk us through the story again?
Tom Sawyer is about an average teenage adolescent boy growing up in the late 1800s in Missouri.
Which students should we be looking out for tonight?
Tonight you can look out for Audrey Kirkpatrick as Aunt Polly and Jacob Friedgood as Tom.
Now tonight is opening night and the show starts at 7 right here in the auditorium. If you can't make it, there are two more shows, tomorrow at 7 and at 2. Tickets are $18 and can be purchased today between 11 and 1 outside the auditorium. Or you can buy online at newcanaanhighschooltheater.com. But you better hurry because today is the last day to buy them. And Berlin, good luck tonight. I'm sure it'll be a great show. This has been Chloe DeMauro with NCTV.
Thanks, Chloe. In other performing arts news, Julian Hough has been selected to perform in Nashville's band concert sponsored by the National Association for Music Education. He is one of the most musically talented clarinetists in the country. Great job, Julian, and good luck playing next week.
While New Canaan is always buzzing with the performing arts, we can't forget about the excellent performances on the playing field.
Well, I haven't forgotten about our athletes, Brendan, but you're in the wrong chair for sports this week.
Well, Finley giving us the rundown on the Rams' push to the playoffs is our newest sports anchor, JP McMahon. JP, it's all yours.
Thank you, Brendan. Hello, NCHS, and welcome to another edition of the Rams Sports Report. I'm JP McMahon. We've got a lot to get to, and I've got to get back to Amstead, so let's get right to it. Boys soccer welcomed West Hill to the pitch on Monday. As always, NCTV was there, so let's hop aboard that highlight train. The boys getting ready and looking to net a senior night victory in their second-to-last game of the season. We join the action in the first half. Senior Harry Stanton drives wide and sends the cross to an open Brett House, who finds the back of the net with a header goal as the Rams will go up 1-0. But that wouldn't stop West Hill as they sneak one through the keeper's hands here late in the second half to tie it up at 2. West Hill making one last push at the Rams' net in the final seconds, but they will be stopped by the Rams' defense, finishing out the game with a final score of 2-2. The girls' team had an up-and-down week, crushing Stanford 5-0 on Tuesday before falling short in a 5-1 loss at the hands of St. Joe's yesterday. Fresh off of Wednesday's 3-1 victory over Ludlow, field hockey begins their FCAC playoff run tomorrow when they host Ridgefield on Dunning at 3:30. Also tomorrow, the boys and girls cross-country teams make the trek up to Manchester, Connecticut to compete in states. Good luck to all those participating. Girls swimming and diving ended their regular season with a win at Trumbull last Friday and a loss, sadly, against Darien on Wednesday by scores of 186 and 116-70, respectively. They will begin competing in FCACs on Monday. Last Friday, girls volleyball lost to Ridgefield 3-0, but bounced back with a 3-1 win against Norwalk on Wednesday. They head over to Harding tonight for their final match of the season. A team nowhere near the end of their season is the football team. Currently standing at 6-0, the boys in red invited someone from outside the Nutmeg State last Friday and demolished the Chicopee Pacers from Chicopee, Massachusetts, 48-20. But the domination will be met by the Rams' toughest test of the season tonight when they travel to Staples to battle the Wreckers. From the field to the water, crew senior Mary Campbell took first place in the girls' youth single event at the head of the Charles Regatta in Boston this past Sunday. To put the achievement in perspective, the head of the Charles is the largest regatta in the world with competitors from all around the globe. Congrats, Mary, on a job well done. Well, that wraps up my first broadcast. Until next time, NCHS, I'm Jaden McMahon.
Thanks, JP. Students, it's time to hit the books because the end of the first quarter is on Halloween next Thursday, October 31st. Get all of your assignments in or your grade might give you a scare. For those of you who need to bring your Spanish grade up, the students of the Spanish Honor Society are offering drop-in tutoring. The schedule of available periods is posted on both doors to the World Language Office.
And the day after the quarter closes is the dreaded college app deadline. One deadline you don't have to worry about are senior yearbook ads because they are now due December 1st, not November 1st. Check your school email for tutorials on how to submit all of your yearbook pieces. If you have any questions, email yearbook advisor Mr. Zambrano at james.zambrano@ncps-k12.org.
One date that is not pushed back is your deadline for your Naviance goals. You all started them in your last mentoring advisory, and they are due today. Your goals will be reviewed at the next advisory. If you have any questions, stop by the guidance office.
While you're online entering your goals, why not try out Google Plus? You can make circles with your project partners, clubs, or a group of your friends. There is even a directory of the entire NCHS community. So, Finley, it got pretty cold here at the end of this week. What can we expect weather-wise from the weekend? Will the temperature warm up at all?
Well, Wednesday I definitely had to pull out my ski jacket, Brendan, but it looks like it's finally going to get warmer. Today will be mostly sunny with a high of 50 degrees. Saturday will be mostly sunny again with a high of 54 degrees. And Sunday it might get a little rainy with a high of 55 degrees.
Sounds like a beautiful weekend, Finley. I'm going to go play in the leaves. Before we end this morning's show, we want to remind you that if you want your announcement on the broadcast, all you have to do is email us at nctv78@gmail.com, or you can tweet at us at nctv78. We're always retweeting. I'm Brendan Baker.
And I'm Finley Walker. We leave you now with a look at how Randy the Ram loves to celebrate Halloween.